children of the Burmese refugee community in New Delhi live in a pathetic state. Most of them are child laborers. Social and economic situation at home force them to an atmosphere where they are exploited, paid little and overworked. Fatigued after toiling for over 10 hours, Delhi education seems a distant dream for them.
We were told that we had to work for 9 hours starting at 8 a.m. But we are made to work up to 10 hours without overtime. We carry heavy sacks of rice. We suffer from fatigue but are not allowed to rest. We are paid a paltry rupees 50 a day. During the interview for the job, we were promised rupees 3000 a month. But we get rupees 2000. Instead of being in school, I go to work because my family needs all the money we can make. We hide in the workplace if the police come by. Severe financial constraints among the Burmese refugee community forces children to work when they should be in school. Those in the age group of 14, 15 and 16 go to work to help their family survive.
New Delhi is home to nearly 8,000 Burmese refugees and 3,000 of them are underage. Almost all need to work to eke out a living, according to the Chin refugee community in India's capital, New Delhi. Instances of humiliation by locals of Burmese child workers make them socially shy and most lack in confidence to stand up for their rights for fear of retribution.
We work hard to the best of our ability, washing the plates and cleaning the floor. But still, we are treated harshly by our boss. It is for the country and its government concern to come down heavily on the use of child labor, as has been made mandatory by international law. The United Nations needs to act in the event of the law on child labor being flouted. Recruiting child soldiers tantamount to violation of not only national but international law as well. Punishment should be handed out in the event of violation.
Unfortunately, as I said, that the only policy in South Asia is a SAARC regional convention trafficking of women and children for prostitution and nothing else. So any child who we find in child labor situation, any child that we find in any other situation, there is no official policy for repatriation and rehabilitation. We can enforce the law against the employer, we can prosecute the employer, we can recover the fine from the employer, but all those access to money from the government cannot be given to the Burmese child. These children from Burma especially and also from Bangladesh are more dependent on the organizations such as ours, NGOs, running their own shelter homes, providing their own services. So therefore, in these cases, we are finding it very difficult, and these children are mostly dependent upon NGOs. There is no state policy on that, unfortunately.
There are over 70,000 child soldiers in the Burmese military and other ethnic armed groups, according to international human rights estimates. Abuse of child rights is rampant in Burma. Fleeing from the inhuman situation in the country, Burmese refugees arrive in India with hope for a better future. The United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees recommends schooling for the children of refugees, but most cannot go to school. The desperate need to survive in a harsh environment in an aligned country forces them into child labor.